Just a Muslim American sister in Niqab, sharing her life's ups and downs with everyday trials and faith in Allah, and well, just living the Niqabi life.
Assalamu alaykum, everybody. Good morning. It's jumu'ah, 8:05 in the morning, and I'm home. I decided to stay home today because I'm just not feeling good at all. I feel no better than I did yesterday. My glands are swollen. I feel really sick and tired and run down and just all out awful. So once again, I'm home. I'm gonna rest. I think I'm gonna do the same as I did Wednesday, where I'm just gonna focus on resting and work on my health, getting that. I'm just gonna rest and feed myself spiritually with Qur'an and Quranic study. I think today I want to go to Masjid Salaam. I miss the masjid and I just want to go and sit in the tranquil place. And Masjid Salaam is that place I want to sit in when I'm not feeling all that great. So I would go to Tarbiyah, but I think I want to go to Salaam today and just sit and contemplate and read and just be quiet and just be there. Just be in the moment. Be with Allah Ta'ala. Yeah. Oopsies. You need to make wudu. Made it. You sure?
Inside this individual, and there are certain things that is written for him. The first thing, ajaluhu, his lifespan, how much he's going to live. For every single person is decided before they arrive into this world. And not only that, but also it is decided when and where you are going to die. I was just hearing an incident of an old lady. She was traveling. She was coming from one country, or she was coming to the United States. And she died on the plane. She died on the plane. So my wife and I, we were having this discussion. I told her, there has to be a country in the middle where her death was written, and as soon as she crossed that country, the angel of the Lord came and took the soul away. So for every individual, it is a place written. فَإِذَا جَاءَ أَجَلُهُمْ فَلَا يَسْتَأْخِرُونَ سَاعَةً وَلَا يَسْتَقْدِمُونَ. Allah says, when your sa'ah comes, when the limit that has been given to you comes, neither you can earn a second, nor you will be able to lose a second. It's that appointed time for every individual they come into this world. And that has been decided before the arrival of the individual. As the hadith of Sahih Muslim states, that Allah Azza wa Jalla writes your lifespan, how much you're going to live. So the life that is given to every individual, it's not earned, it's been given. It's not earned. A person says, well, you know, I worked really hard, that's why I have been given this life. No. You worked after you came into this world. It wasn't given to you before. And it's been decided by Allah how long you're going to live on earth. And this has already been given to you by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So no matter what you do, neither you can decrease it from your life, nor you can increase it from your life. And it's in the decision of Allah when He's going to act. The second thing that the second blessing of Allah Azza wa Jalla, which is one of the greatest blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is your risk and sustenance and your wealth. Everything that you have. Everything that you have. And this is also something called maqdur. Allah has written the risk for you. How much are you going to consume on earth? The minute your risk finish, that's the minute your life finish. Not a single person, he is going to leave a morsel behind and leave from this world and leaving a morsel behind for other people to use. No. Whatever has been written for every individual, they will eat it, they will finish it. The minute a person's life finishes, because why is life finished? Because there is no risk on earth left for him. Whatever risk he had, whatever assistance he had on this earth, he's already consumed it. So the birth does not have the ability to offer him with more, because his limit is already over. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إِنَّ نَفْسٍ لَمْ تَمُوتَ حَتَّى تَسْتَكْمِلَ رِزْقَهَا فَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ وَأَجْمِلُوا فِي الطَّلَبِ فَإِنَّمَا عِنْدَ اللَّهِ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى لَا يُخَذُ إِلَّا بِطَاعَتِهِ وَلَا يَسْتَبْطِئَنَّكُمْ إِسْتِبْطَاءُ الرِّزْقِ وَلَا يَحْمِلَنَّكُمْ إِسْتِبْطَاءُ الرِّزْقِ أَنْ يَأْخُذُوا بِمَعَصِيَةِ اللَّهِ. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, no soul should depart from this world until their sustenance finishes from the earth. The risk finishes, that's the day you leave from this world. إِنَّ نَفْسًا لَنْ تَمُوتَ حَتَّى تَسْتَكْمِلَ رِزْقَهَا. So what you need to do? You need to fear Allah Azza wa Jalla. وَأَثْمِلُوا فِي الطَّلَبِ. Adopt the best way in earning that sustenance. Adopt the way which is loved by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So both of these great gifts of Allah, why Allah has given to us? Ayah number 111. Surah number 9. إِنَّ اللَّهَ اشْتَرَى مِنَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ أَنفُسَهُمْ وَأَمْوَالَهُمْ بِأَنَّ لَهُمُ الْجَنَّةَ. أنفس أموال. Allah says, we have given you your life, we have given you your wealth, and we have told you to use it, and we have already utilized it to earn Jannah for you. So life has been given to every individual, wealth has been given to every individual to do what? Why Allah gave me this gift? Just because I was looking nice? I was tall? I was handsome? No. Allah gave it to you for a purpose. بِأَنَّ لَهُمُ الْجَنَّةِ. So you can earn paradise through it. You can make your akhirah through this. So these are the two great blessings of Allah which needs to be used according to the order of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So these are the two things that needs to be utilized according to the orders of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which are the greatest gift of Allah azza wa jalla. Now it's easier said than done. Why? Because there are three obstacles which is with every individual that is making this person stop from getting that ultimate success. What's the ultimate success? The ultimate success is utilizing your life and your wealth according to the orders of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The person who does this, Allah gives him ultimate success. Now it's easier said than done. Why? Because there are three great obstacles. The first obstacle is what? It's your nafs, your desire. Because everyone is living on what they want to do. I want to do this, I like this, I'm going to do this because I like it, I want it. Everyone is living on the standards of wants. No one is living on the standards of needs. And who's the second obstacle for receiving this ultimate success that is becoming in front of us? It's our best friend, Shaitan. Right? Allah Azza wa Jalla says in the Qur'an, إِنَّهُ لَكُمْ عَدُوٌ مُّبِينٌ. He is your enemy. Don't make him as your friend. Keep it that way. Allah says he's your enemy and keep it that way. Make sure he stays your enemy. And Shaitan is someone that stays with every individual. Either how, no matter how much pious you become, or how wicked you are, Shaitan stays with you at all times. And what's his effort? His effort is to make you go away from the right path. Environment. The environment that we live in. Every individual has an environment of their own. Either that environment inspires them to do good, or that environment inspires them to do bad. Al-mar'u 'ala dini khalilihi falyanzur ahadukum man yukhalil. The Prophet ﷺ said, a person lives on the standards of his friend's religion. His circle, the people that he hangs around with, the people that he sits and stands up with. And those type of people that a person just bees like when he is sitting around with them. That's the environment which is the greatest obstacle. If a person wants to do a good thing, he's not able to do. Why? Because he has been forced into peer pressure. People are not letting him to do good things. You know, you're sitting in a gathering of sophisticated people, great intelligent individuals, and the salah time approaches and you stand up and you say, I want to go and pray my salah. And everyone start looking at him. You pray? Really? This person feels embarrassed, and next time he doesn't even mention that he wants to pray. What took him away from his prayers? It's the environment. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Kullu mawludin yuladu ala fitra." Every child is born on the basis belief of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, on fitra. فَأَبَوَاهُ يُهَوِّدَانِهِ أَوْ يُوَجِّسَانِهِ أَوْ يُنَسَّرَانِهِ. The environment that is found in the house, that's how the child becomes. And it's not just for the child. As it grows, becomes an adult, environment changes a person. Environment is a means of taking you away from good actions, and also is a means of taking you closer to good actions. So that's the third obstacle which is coming in the life of an individual, which is stopping this individual from receiving the ultimate success.
Assalamu alaikum everybody. It's jumu'ah, it's 2:54, and I'm at Master Salaam. I haven't been here in quite a long time. Alhamdulillah, it's so good to be back to the first place I call home, first place I feel most comfortable and most at peace. I haven't showed you guys this masjid in a long time, and you see it in one of my 2016 vlogs. So let me show you what it looks like in here. Thank you. really good to be back here again, alhamdulillah. I'm still not feeling good. I've been having the chills all day. I probably shouldn't have come out, but I just wanted to be at a place where I feel the most at peace and the most tranquil, and where I can just, you know, be with Allah Ta'ala. I don't know. I just wanted to be here today. If I could be nowhere else, I just wanted to be here today. So my daughter and I came here, and it was a good jumu'ah, and it was good to pray amongst the, you know, the sisters and brothers here. It's just nice to see familiar faces I haven't seen in a long time too. So alhamdulillah for that. And my daughter, she's enjoying her time. She met up with a couple of friends, so she's, you know, running around with them right now. So we're going to be leaving in about a couple of minutes, inshallah. It's pretty hot, I'm sure, right about now, so I'm not really looking forward to going out. But I'm going to have to go home eventually, right? And plus, my battery is flashing, and I have no replacement battery. And as a matter of fact, I got a notification that my vlogging camera is being shipped. So inshallah, I may have my camera tomorrow or Sunday or something, inshallah. So it'll be good to have my camera back again. A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim. Bismillahir rahmanir rahim. Waylul lil mutaffifin. الذين إذا اكتالوا على الناس يستوفون وإذا كالوهم أو وزنوهم يخسرون ألا يظن أولئك أنهم مبعوثون ليوم عظيم يوم يقوم الناس لرب العالمين كلا إن كتاب الفجار لفي سجين وما أدراك ما سجين كتاب مرقوم ويل يومئذ للمكذبين الذين يكذبون بيوم الدين وما يكذب به إلا كل معتد أثيم إذا تتلى عليه آياتنا قال أساطير الأولين كلا بل ران على قلوبهم ما كانوا يكسبون كلا إنهم عن ربهم يومئذ لمحجوبون ثم إنهم لصالو الجحيم ثم يقال هذا الذي كنتم به تكذبون كلا إن كتاب الأبرار لفي عليين وما أدراك ما عليون كتاب مرقوم يشهده المقربون إن الأبرار لفي نعيم على الأرائك ينظرون تعرف في وجوههم نضرة النعيم يسقون من رحيق مختوم ختامه مسك وفي ذلك فليتنافس المتنافسون ومزاجه من تسنيم عين يشرب بها المقربون السلام عليكم everybody. It's 7:37. I've been practicing Surah Al-Mutaffifin off and on, just off and on. Is it clear? Better?
Ooh, pretty.
Oh, I like that.
Your abaya looks white.
My who?
Your abaya looks lavender. Oh. Just see if it looks lavenderish.
Oh. Anyways. So we've been home for a while, and like I said, I'm not going to say we, because it's only me. I've been practicing the Quran. She's trying to do paper figures. Cut out paper figures. Using characters from the story, Ember in the Ashes and a Torch Against the Night. Is that what it is? Torch Against the Night?
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Yeah. I'm still not feeling any better. I've been struggling with the chills, like hardcore chills, and just feeling plain awful all day long. The only thing that gave me peace was when I went to Salaam, just to be there. I seem to flock there when I'm at my lowest or when I don't feel good at all. And I wasn't at my lowest. I just plain old just, I was sick, just feeling completely sick, and I just needed to get out of here, and I just needed to be in the one place that makes me at peace and tranquil and happy, and that was go to Masjid Salaam, and I did, alhamdulillah. I wish I could just stay there all weekend long, because, but I don't need to. I have no plans for this weekend except to try and work on my wellness and just rest and more rest. I don't have any plans for anything, mostly because that I'm sick, and two, I have no money to go do anything, really. Yeah. Why? You are a horrible person.
No curiouses. She's the worst of the worst.
And Keenan.
He's not horrible!
You.
He's not the Nightbringer. I told you for the bajillionth time. He.
Can you watch your tone of voice with me, please?
He is not the Nightbringer. I've made that up.
You shouldn't have said such things. Because now I still have doubts about this character.
I mean, why did I open my big mouth?
Why did she open her big mouth?
You can't say that.
I just did.
Take it back.
I shall not. Because you shouldn't have said that Keenan was a bad person. And now that's all I think.
He's not bad.
Well, you planted the seed. You planted the seed. And I'm having a chill attack right now. Not funny. Why do you always gotta laugh at something like that? I'm trying to wait for it to pass. I'm shivering a little bit. See, now you made me forget what I was going to say.
Nightbringer.
And you were being
seed.
Rude.
Nightbringer seed.
You planted the seed, and now the seed has taken root and is growing. Now I have to wait until I get to the end of the book to see if Keenan is really a bad person or not. Because you planted the seed.
It was an accidental planting.
That was no accidental planting. You.
It was a planting that I intended to uproot.
Well, you better. You can't uproot it because now I gotta go to the end of the book.
Uproot it, Umi. Uproot it.
Don't snap your scissors at me. She's a cruel person.
I am not.
Cruel.
And not.
When are you going to do the dishes?
After dessert.
There's going to be more dishes.
I know. When all the dishes will be put in the dishes.
Well, then guess what? Heat up a kettle of water, because even though I'm shivering and going through the chills of a lifetime right now and feeling really crappy, I think maybe ramen will kind of simmer that a little bit, even if just for a minute.
Simmer down.
Ooh, do I still have the, it looks like the onions, but it's the big one.
Cha-cha.
It's cha-cha-cha-cha.
Cha-cha-cha.
Yeah.
Boom, boom, ba.
I'm going to have ramen, and then I'm going to have...
Dessert.
Dessert. Oh, I still have to see that movie.
What movie?
The one from Netflix.
Moana?
No, the one that came in the mail.
Oh, Thor 2.
How was it?
We need to watch the first one again.
We didn't watch the first one?
We did.
We did?
Yes, we just have to watch the second. You just need to watch it again and then we can watch
the second
one.
So should I send that back and get the first one and then request it again?
Yes, and then we can get the third one.
There's a third?
Yes.
There's a third Thor movie?
Yes.
You lie.
I know lie.
There's a third? I don't even remember watching the first. I didn't know there was a first. I thought that was the first.
I remember
I thought
first.
That was just the only one.
I remember the first.
I didn't think that had a first and a third.
I thought it was just the one.
I remember the first.
It sounds so wrong to say the one.
You're the one.
Not for me.
You're the one for yourself.
You're the one to take down this witch.